my first video. I give so much credit to people that do these videos because I didn't realize how much lighting is a big factor in these kind of videos, and as soon as I turned my camera on, the battery died, so that was cool, but I'm here, I made it. Hopefully the lighting's not too bad. I don't know why I'm doing this. Okay, so what I'm gonna do for you guys, I'm just gonna show you like a little casual 4th of July look. I'm wearing just kind of like a simple white tee with this little red scarf my friend gave me. She has this cute little boutique. It's called On Next Sunday. It's in El Paso, Texas, if you live in the area or live in El Paso, check it out. But this is kind of cute. I love it. And I feel like that's what I'm going to wear for the July, like a cute little denim jacket and probably black jeans, dark jeans. And then I have my hair curled from earlier today. It's kind of a mess, but I'm going to show you guys kind of my look that I'm gonna do, kind of like a rough draft. I don't really know what I'm gonna do yet, but hopefully you guys enjoy and just keep on watching. I'm gonna get started and I'm gonna start off with just prepping my skin. So I'm gonna look kind of crazy, but I'll pull my hair back just because I know I'm not the only one that hates having their hair in their face when they're doing their makeup. All right, so I'm gonna prep my skin with the Milani Make It Last little setting spray. Let's use it as primer too. Feels so refreshing, but let's dry a little bit. And I'm gonna use the MAC Prep and Prime skin base. This little sample I got. Alright, that's all I need. It has a little bit of reflect in it, so it's really pretty. And then I'm going to use the NYX Angel Veil Primer. My best friend got me this. Just be using it. And I'm just, my mirror is right here, so that's why I'm looking that way. But just rub it in. I like to kind of rub it on it. A lot of priming, but I like my skin to look very healthy, so I'm going to use the Physicians Formula Argan Oil. Try not to get it where you put your smoothing primer. I just want to use that. My skin looks so plump and luminous and healthy. So now, I'm going to take my IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Breakout Concealer. I'm just going to apply that on the breakouts. I know some people don't do their makeup like this, but for me, I do a light skin coverage. Just going to pat that in with your finger. I'm not the only one that puts on concealer before foundation. I know there's someone out there that does it too. Okay, so I'm just taking a little bit of the Makeup Forever HD foundation. So I'm just using my little Eco Tool sponge. I love it. It's so soft. I actually like it better than the Real Techniques one. Shocker, I used that one for a long time. So I'm just doing a little light wash over my face. Not too crazy. Okay, so I'm gonna take my favorite concealer back here. I can't get away from this one. It is the Maybelline Fit Me. It's so light. And I like it to be really brightening. But I like a yellowy undertone for my under eye concealer too. So I never put it like fully right underneath the eye. I leave some space. and I bring it down. Ugliest faces when I do my makeup. I'm sure I'm not alone. I just feel like I need to stretch out like my skin. I'm about to turn 25 and I feel like my skin's like changed a lot within the past year. And now people are probably looking at me like, you're crazy. But I really feel like it's changed a lot. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Alright. So I'm going to take my Cover FX. This has lasted me a really long time, mostly just because I only use it for special occasions. So like for 4th of July, I'm definitely going to use this. It's a little setting powder. I love it. I'm going to take, all my brushes are kind of random, so I don't really want to suggest my brushes to you guys because they're very old. And this one's new. This is from my Ipsy bag. It's Firma 102. I've never heard of it before, but I'm actually really fond of it. And I've been using it for... powder. So I'll just go underneath the eye. I don't like to do baking because I feel like because of these newfound lines I have underneath my eyes, I don't want to emphasize them. So I'm just going to go really gently. And this powder has no talc. Lauren, she suggested this to me. Correct me if I'm wrong. But I think this has no talc, which basically makes the skin look more hydrated. Like powders that have talc in it make your skin look dry, is what she told me. But, so yeah, and I believe that to be true. I feel like that is definitely the case from this powder. That's what sets it apart from other powders. I don't really use this all over my face. I take my Pixie, something I got at Target. Some Targets don't carry it, and some do. And this is the color correcting powder. Cheeks so that my bronzer doesn't apply super muddy. Try not to do right here, that way my highlighter has something to stick to. Weirdly enough, I like to apply my highlighter one of the first things I do, and then at the very end I put more on. So I'm gonna take that same little setting spray and a little highlighting brush, and just I'm gonna take my favorite, it's broken. But it is the e.l.f. Moonlight Pearls Highlighter. This is my go-to. You guys can see it's well-loved. Just kind of get in there. I have to apply it right there. That is my spot right there. Like a little half moon, little half moon. I mean, can you even handle that? I can't. I'm about to pass out. This is so beautiful. This is my favorite highlighter. Like, honestly, I will wear this on my wedding day. Sometimes I like to put it a little bit underneath the brow, too. My brows look really dark in this camera. I think it's just the lighting. I need to hurry up before the sun goes down. So, if you notice, I did downverge my nose on the tip of my nose. Cupid's bow, chin. I'm done with my highlighter. I'm gonna do a little bit of bronzer. I'm going to take a little brush. This is, I know this one, Luxie Brushes. This is the 522, and I use this to contour slash bronze. So I'm going to take my Milani Baked Bronzer, like number 04 Glow. It has this beautiful reflect in it. Just gives more glow. A little bit of my sunscreen. More shapely. Not too much though, girl. You white. We're not trying to fake our ethnicity. Okay, so this one too, the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula. It's the Wet n Wild Rose Champagne Blush. Summer Line Babe. too much on, because, girl. But what I love about this blush is it's so subtle. Does anybody have, like, a favorite side? This is my favorite side. This is not. This is my favorite side. I'm happy with that. Okay. So now, I have four eyeshadow choices for you guys. Some are high-end and hard to acquire, so don't at me, okay? But this one is the cheapest one. I think it's between the $3 to $5 range, okay? This is so beautiful. It is the I will find out for you guys. Jess is using this brown like all over your lid, and then maybe this in the inner corner. Girl, if you don't have a man, you will, because that eyeshadow is popping. It's gonna make your eyes pop. This is the NYX Warm Neutrals palette. This one I think can range between like $15 to $18. Look at my hand. Hey! This one's so beautiful though. I love it. It's so beautiful. It serves so many looks. This is a well-loved eyeshadow, guys. I literally just put that shade, this one right here, all over my lid, and I kind of just like blend it out. Call it a day. It's beautiful. And then my Tartlet in Bloom palette. Isn't she pretty? Oh. You're not ready. This is a well-loved shade. Oh my gosh. Oh, but girl, this shade right here, same. All over the lid, in the crease. It also smells like vanilla-y, chocolatey cupcakes. Oh, so good. And then, our favorite sister, Jaclyn Hill. We don't like her, we can't be friends, okay? And I love this sweet little note she put in there for all of her subscribers. I die. Look at all these colors, guys. If you want an eyeshadow palette that will serve you every kind of look and kind of be like funky and creative, this is your girl right here. Just take a look at her. Just take a look. Just look at her. She's gorgeous. So I may use that one. But for the sake of the video, I'll probably use the Warm Neutrals palette. And like I said, I'm going to take my trusty, well-loved brown eyeshadow. So just tap in. I start in the crease first. Do a little bit. I could probably do my eyeshadow like blindfolded. Just take her underneath the eye. Guys, smoky eyes, you just kind of bring it down underneath the eye. And then kind of a little bit in that corner. She's cute. I like it. Okay. I'm gonna take her same brown shadow. Guys, it's this easy. It's this easy. You say, I don't know how to do my eyeshadow, and you watch this video and you don't know how to do your eyeshadow, I'm gonna be very upset with you, because it's just so easy, and I'm making it look. That's just all you gotta do. Now, doing your eyeshadow intricate, you just gotta watch a lot of videos. Don't watch mine, because I'm not a pro. Watch Jaclyn Hill. If you wanna learn how to do your eyeshadow, she will teach you. I promise, give it a month, and she will teach you. For the sake of this video, I was gonna do eyelashes. But girl, I ain't going anywhere and I don't wanna waste my lashes that I bought for the 4th of July. So I'll show you guys in another video. Maybe I'll have time that day to film. I'm not sure, probably not. Cause it's gonna be my anniversary. My 1 year with my boo Andrew. Feel like mascara brings everything together. because right now I feel like I look like I should be in a movie Beetlejuice, you know? Teeny tiny little elf brush. It already has some inner corner highlight on there. I'm gonna take this little champagne. This one. She cute. Inner corner highlights, guys. It saves lives. And it makes looks look so much better. Guys, I'm listening to a song right now. I'm just listening to a song loop, which is like all the time. This e.l.f. eyelash curler is literally probably $1 to $3. It's so good. Take my favorite mascara right now. Maybelline Lash Sensational. I always wanted to call it Colossal, but it's Sensational. Like, look what that does already. Another good one too when it comes to mascara, I'm gonna show you guys. The Almay Thickening Mascara. If you have really, well, kind of long but fine eyelashes, or even have naturally beautiful lashes and you use this, don't come talk to me because they're gonna look so good. I'm gonna be mad at you. I think it's just hard for you guys to see, but like, you'll know what I mean if you like. You'll know what I mean. Now, the pièce de résistance, the Rimmel Stay Matte Liquid Lipstick in Firestarter. Girl, actually, what are you doing, girl? Chill out. Line your lips first. I'm gonna take the NYX Suede Matte Lip Liner. This shade Soft Spoken is like my lips, but better. And it helps kinda like overline. From Kylie, so thanks, Kylie. She's cute. I kind of just purse my lips together. So I'm gonna do that lipstick again. This is my favorite red in the whole world, and it's very cheap. I feel like everything I'm using is super cheap because I can't afford all the expensive makeup. I feel like I take the longest on my lipstick and my eyebrows because it's such a nerve-wracking own eyeliner. So that's her. She's cute, right? I know. Guys, this lip, this red lip looks good on everybody. Everybody. And I feel like red lipstick just boosts your confidence. I'm gonna take this metallic liquid eyeliner. I got it from the jewelry box, which is like a El Paso, it's a very inexpensive jewelry makeup that has a lot of stuff there. They have individual lashes there too, which is what I'm going to use on the 4th of July just to make my eyes pop a little bit more. So what I do is I'm just going to take this. Like open up your eyes and everyone's gonna be like, oh, that's fun. I'm gonna be like, hey, Elena from Corny. Tell me about it from me. Let your hair down, girl. With individual lashes, I feel like this look will look a lot better. Brow pencil in ash brown. A little spoolie on there, and I love this thing. So, brush my brows down, fill in the top, starting to get really hot in my room. I can feel it. Summer, am I right? Guys, this pencil is everything. I'm almost going to cry. It's beautiful. Did fill in super lightly. Now I'm gonna take the Essence Make Me Brow. It's $2.99. Can't beat that price. You just can't. Brush them up. I like that fluffy, sassy brow. This is the look. You can finish it off with a little denim jacket draped under your shoulders. If you're going somewhere at night, obviously during the day, that's a stupid idea because it's friggin' hot in El Paso, so don't do that. But for me, I'm gonna be at church, so I'm just gonna wear my little denim jacket and call it a day. On the actual day, I suggest to pop a little bit of individual lashes or lash strip, or just wear your normal lashes if you're happy with your normal lashes. Me personally, mine are really small, so I don't really love them that much, but do you, girl, do you. Wear some hoops, wear some cute little earrings, paint your nails nice and fun. I just did a little bit of long nail action, and have fun. Yeah, this is my finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Subscribe, like this video, comment down below. I'd love to get to know you guys, and I am open to suggestions for videos, so comment down below, and yeah, thanks for watching.